Fae's Refuge, Queens of the Fae, Book 8, written by M. Lynn and Melissa A. Craven, narrated by Olivia King. Chapter 1. Siobhan. She couldn't stop moving. Siobhan McGowan had never been in the human realm before, not until a few weeks ago when she entered a portal unwillingly. Princess Tierney hadn't meant to do it. She was certain of that. They'd known each other since they were little girls running around the palace together. Her friend would never intentionally hurt anyone. But her magic was a different matter. The princess was powerful, and sometimes she didn't know her own strength. Exhaustion warred with her need to get home as she let herself take a break on the grassy hilltop of the Irish countryside. That was what a human had told her this place was called. Ireland. It was beautiful, with lush rolling hills, grazing sheep, and steep cliffs that dropped off into turbulent seas. Yet there was also a starkness to the landscape, one that soothed her. It reminded Siobhan of her home among the rocky mountains of Iskalt. In her weary state, she wasn't sure she could have handled brilliant blue skies or a blazing sun. The gray day suited her. She lay back in the grass, wishing she could close her eyes for just a moment, but now was not the time. She'd come so far, and she was almost there. She could rest when she was home, after she'd delivered her message to the king and queen. In the human lands, there was only one place to enter the Fae realm without portal magic. The Rift. That was what the people of Mirkur called the delicate tear in the veil between their lands and the human realm. 10 years ago, during the war for the prison realm, the Dark Fae King tried to conquer the human world, spilling the darkness of Mirkur through the rift. Now, all that remained to remind them of that time was something Siobhan wasn't even sure she could find. But she wouldn't give up. She had to get home, had to find out what happened to Tierney, Gulliver, and Varen. With a deep sigh, she heaved her tired limbs up to continue toward the clearing where the invisible Fae village of Agadun once stood. At least, that was what she'd heard in the years since the war. She hadn't known that was where she was headed at first. She only knew she could sense the tear, like her home was calling to her. Not with words. She hadn't gone completely insane. But the air buzzed with an energy that pulled at her. It dared her to search the queen's old farmhouse until she found a collection of what humans used for money. It then tugged her across the sea, using all modes of human transportation. At first, it was overwhelming, then exhilarating. She'd always had a secret interest in all things human. She'd even studied the basics of the human world with their flying contraptions and fast ships, but it was so different than she'd expected. Siobhan would pay Queen Bree back if she ever managed to return to Iskalt. For all she knew, she was wandering into the middle of an unfamiliar land with no hope of finding the passage between the worlds, one that wasn't supposed to be visible on this side. But the pull was stronger here. She could feel it pulsing in her veins, calling her home. She didn't want to think about what would happen if she couldn't find it. Every night, she replayed what happened in the portal in her mind. One moment, she'd gripped Tierney so tightly she swore they'd never part. And the next, an unseen power slammed into Siobhan's chest, forcing her back out of the portal. The impact when she'd landed in front of the farmhouse had stolen her breath, but it took her a few moments to realize something had gone very wrong, that she wasn't home in Iskalt, and that she was alone. She only hoped she could find Tierney the moment she arrived in Iskalt, and everything would be all right again. It was what kept her going. "My father will be happy with these new revelations," she mumbled to herself, thinking of how much he hoped she and Tierney would find their way to each other. Talking to herself was a new hobby. It gave her something to hear other than the wind in her ears. It wasn't until the reality of her situation sank in that she realized she truly had hoped the princess would choose her, that they could be happy together. Tierney O'Shea was special. At least, Siobhan thought so. The princess cared about other fae, and she showed it in her every action. There was no one braver or more reckless. If the king truly forced her to marry an Iskaltian noble, Siobhan vowed she would make herself the best candidate for her hand.
"How are you kidding, Siobhan?"
she muttered as she trudged up the next hillside. She would prove no match for the likes of Varin Radigan, with his courtly charm and handsome face, not when she was so utterly rough around the edges. That was what most thought of her. She'd been raised to be her father's heir, the keeper of the mountain boundary between Iskalt and the northern Vatlands, a wild country few could navigate. She would be the Marchioness of Belmore Keep one day, a noble title, but she would always be more comfortable in the saddle than as a lady, curtsying at the right times and saying all the right things. Most fae her age never tried to see past her well-worn leathers or the sword she was rarely without. She might be more warrior than lady, but she was still a prominent member of the noble class, and that alone made her suitable for their future queen's hand in marriage.
"I'll just have to try harder," she vowed. "One more hill."
She clenched her fists as she gave herself a pep talk. Her legs ached, and a sheen of sweat and grime coated her normally matte brown skin. Thankful for the strange human clothes instead of the dress she'd worn to Tierney's ball, she pushed through the burn. Her trousers were made from some kind of black fabric that stretched and moved with each step, and the large shirt hung off one shoulder and let air move underneath it to cool her. Loose dark curls escaped her bun, sticking to the back of her neck, and she pushed them off to get some relief. And then she reached it. The top of the hill, where she could see over the land to the sea. A vast plain stretched across the valley. The rift was close. She could feel her homeland like an old friend calling to her. She wasn't sure what she'd expected to see, but it certainly wasn't this. It wasn't nothing. Yet there was no sign of the always moving village that once inhabited these lands. No sign in the sky directing her where she needed to go. It was a blank canvas of green grass, waiting to be filled with color and hope. But she had no more hope to give. Siobhan dropped to the ground, exhaustion finally winning out. The impact reverberated up her spine. She'd been so sure it was here, that this was the way home. She could still feel it tingling under her skin, that overwhelming sensation that home was just within reach. But maybe she'd put too much hope into a feeling when she had too little to go on. If she'd been smart, she would have stayed at the farmhouse and waited for someone to come find her. They would have, eventually. But Queen Bree was said only to visit her home once or twice a year, that the people knew of. She'd tried to be patient, but after a few days, the inactivity drove her mad. Siobhan needed to know if Tierney and Gulliver were okay. Varin, too, she supposed. She curled her legs up, hugging her knees to her chest. Tears fell from her eyes, tracking through the sweat and dirt on her face.
"Tierney, please be okay."
Anger swept through her. Anger at this realm, at the magic that got her here, at the stupid rift between worlds that had given her so much hope. How had she thought she could find an invisible tear in the sky? Something no one in the human realm was supposed to be able to spot. Her heart ached, but it was the familiar ache that led her here, the one she'd taken as a lead rope guiding her to where she needed to be.
"No, I'm done listening to invisible forces."
Done listening to magic. The ache grew, squeezing her heart until she gasped and clutched her chest. She bent over, trying to breathe. Pain seared through her chest, and she got to her knees.
"Please."
Whatever it was had to stop. It had to let her go. Lifting her eyes to the horizon, she noticed the sky growing dimmer. The clouds blocked out the brilliant colors she'd seen so many times on her journey. But there was no mistaking the setting sun. Was the moon already above her, hidden by the clouds? A drop of rain hit her cheek.
and the rope around her heart pulled tighter. A scream ripped from her lips. It was like her magic was trying to shred her from the inside out, drag her heart right through her chest.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.